Light and electron microscopes. The beauty of biology and all that we know today is due to the invention of microscopes. Microscopes had been available since the beginning of the 17th century, but a lot of improvements were made in the quality of glass lenses in the early 19th century. The branch of biology dealing with microscope design, slide preparation and examination is called cytology. Light microscopy. The light microscope uses light as a source of radiation and has shown us inside cells. It shows us simple structures like the nucleus, the cell wall, and the cell membrane. A light microscope is still used in basic studies in schools today. Electron microscopy. Then came the electron microscopes, which made our microscopic world more detailed. Due to the electron microscopes, we not only saw the cell wall, the nucleus, and the cytoplasm, but we also saw the more minute organelles, like the mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, and the Golgi apparatus. The light microscopes were doing great, but no matter how much their designs improved, there was an extent to which the light microscopes could not show. Anything smaller than 200 nm could not be seen. Electrons are subatomic particles that have a negative electric charge and are found surrounding the nucleus of an atom. When a metal becomes very hot, some of its electrons gain so much energy that they escape from their orbits, like shooting stars. The energy in free electrons is associated with the proportion of waves. The higher the energy, the shorter the wavelength. Electrons are a very suitable form of radiation for a microscope for two major reasons. Firstly, the wavelength is extremely short. And secondly, because they are negatively charged, they can be focused easily using electromagnets. The magnet can be made to alter the path of a beam, similar to how a glass lens made to bend the light. There are two types of electron microscopes in use today: the transmission electron microscope, TEM, and the scanning electron microscope, SEM. In the transmission electron microscope, the beam of electrons is passed through the specimen before being viewed. Only those electrons that are transmitted are seen. This enables us to see different components inside the cells. In a scanning electron microscope, the electron beam is used to scan the surfaces of structures, and only the reflected beam is observed. The advantage of this is that surface structure, for example, like the chitinous outer body of insects, can be seen in great detail.